The world's last free-flowing rivers are under threat. What's commonly thought of as a green solution to the energy crisis is in fact destroying the planet's last remaining pockets of untouched wilderness and intact ecosystems. Before we start, we'd like to tell you that this video is part of a collaboration with the YouTube channel Undecided with Matt Ferrell. Matt explores how sustainable and smart technologies impact our lives. This time, he's diving deep into the technology behind hydropower, which we'll tell you more about later on. Today, there are roughly 60,000 large dams around the world. 3,700 more are currently planned or under construction. Over 500 of them will be built in protected areas. At first sight, the concept of hydropower is a simple one. Flowing water is trapped in front of dams, then directed through turbines which spin to generate electricity. It may seem like a green solution to meeting the world's growing electricity demand, but it's actually a dirty one. Dams emit greenhouse gases, endanger fish species, and can uproot communities. So all this leads us to the question, what is the true cost of hydropower? To understand the environmental impact of hydropower, we first have to understand the value and characteristics of a free-flowing river. In a wild river, animals such as migratory fish can swim up and downstream at will. Groundwater and aquifers naturally refresh the water. Silt and other natural materials can move along freely. The water moves out onto the floodplain in harmony with the seasons, delivering important nutrients to wildlife and other habitats, signaling fish to spawn, and bringing nutrients back into the river itself. The sad news is that there aren't many wild rivers left. Two-thirds of them are already dammed. And that number is increasing every day. What started with old-fashioned water wheels has developed into modern hydroelectric plants embedded in dams to generate power. Currently, 22% of the world's electricity is provided by renewable resources, 73% of which is hydropower. But although hydropower is renewable, it isn't green. Building a large barrier like a dam destroys the single most important thing about a river, its flow. Both the reduced downstream flow and the reservoir upstream can destroy wildlife habitats and farmland, either through drying out or flooding. A dam also changes the structure of a river. It slows the flow of water, which means that sediments like sand or gravel hit the dam and then drop to the riverbed. In a way, dams are thus creating big underwater sandboxes, and these are bad news for fish which depend on clean, rocky bottoms. The clustered sediments aren't good for the dam itself either, because as the area in front of it is filled up with more and more sediment, it holds less and less water. Dams don't just form a barrier for sediment, but also mean a drastic impact on flora and fauna. When the flow of a river is blocked, fish can't reach their spawning grounds. And over time, dammed rivers can lead to drastically reduced fish populations. Currently, the most common way of solving this migration problem is installing fish ladders. Fish ladders are stepped pools, which allow fish to swim or jump from one pool to another, all the way up and behind the dam. But in most cases, they don't actually work very well. The structures are often too high or too steep, too small to support massive migrations, or not able to hold enough water. Even if fish ladders do succeed, they might work for fish like salmon, but not for all types of fish, because some, like eels, can't jump. Blocked migration routes aren't the only problem. Reservoir water usually contains an excess of algae or other aquatic weeds, which can crowd out other animal and plant life. The water in reservoirs is typically also low in dissolved oxygen and colder than normal river water. When this water is released from time to time, it can have a bad impact on wildlife. As a result of all these negative consequences, worldwide populations of freshwater species have already experienced a staggering 83% decline since 1970. More dams will likely further deplete their numbers. Despite all these aspects, there's a popular consensus that hydropower is a vital element for the energy industry shift away from fossils. But one fundamental piece of information is missing from the argument. It might sound counterintuitive at first, but hydropower is not emission-free. Around 10% of the world's hydropower facilities emit as many greenhouse gases as conventional fossil-fueled power plants. Some existing dams in the lowland Amazon have even been shown to be up to 10 times more carbon-intensive than coal-fired power plants. Generating power by spinning turbines with water doesn't directly emit greenhouse gases. So where do they come from? When reservoirs cover organic matter like dead plants, trees, fields, and farmland, they produce greenhouse gases, especially in warm climates. The organic material breaks down and releases gases like carbon dioxide and methane into the reservoir water. And these are the two major greenhouse gases associated with climate change. Worldwide, the rotting vegetation in reservoirs represents 1.3% of the total annual global emissions caused by humans. This is alarming, but it also shows that there's potential to improve the current situation. And here's how. Hydropower needs to be viewed as part of a broader strategy for energy, in which the costs and benefits of different sources should be assessed and weighed against each other. A strategic mix of solar, wind, and storage technologies around river basins could be an option. Greater investments need to be made in detailed upfront planning and environmental impact assessments, which should be carried out by independent scientists. Existing dams should be upgraded and retrofitted where possible, instead of building new ones. And fish passage systems need to be optimized to make it more friendly for all different kinds of fish. Sounds like a lot of work, right? But it's finally getting started. In October 2020, several environmental groups and the industry that operates America's hydroelectric dams announced an unusual agreement to work together to reduce the environmental harm caused by dams. They're also going to join forces to remove older dams that are no longer needed. More than 1,000 dams nationwide have already been torn down in recent decades. In many of these places, such as the Elwha River in Washington State, nature has come roaring back, with fish populations increasing. It's expected that if this trend continues, between 4,000 and 36,000 more dams will have been removed in the U.S. by 2050. The world's free-flowing rivers are crucial for the environment and humans alike. And it's now more important than ever that we choose wisely whether we really want to build new dams. It's about finding the right balance between hydropower and rivers, but also more generally, between energy consumption and ecosystem conservation.
Hi there. Be sure to check out the video from Undecided with Matt Ferrell. He talks about the technical solutions which can make hydropower more environmental friendly. Matt has done an amazing job. You will see detailed animations, new turbine technologies, and examples for tidal energy. We've linked to the video right here.